A team of researchers at UC San Diego Health may have just developed a new breakthrough blood test aimed at detecting a type of pulmonary hypertension which can lead to heart failure.
And those findings were just published in Nature Medicine. Here to talk more about this is Dr. Patricia Thistlethwaite, a cardiothoracic surgeon at UC San Diego Health and also one of the authors of that paper. Thank you so much for being here today.
Thank you.
So we'll start off, for those who may not know, what is pulmonary hypertension?
Pulmonary hypertension is a constellation of diseases that all result in high blood pressure in the lungs.
And what about the research that's been done?
Well, we study a particular form of pulmonary hypertension called idiopathic pulmonary arterial hypertension. And this disease affects both men and women, but more commonly women, at any age, but most commonly between the ages of 20 and 50 when people are in the prime of their lives. Mm-hmm. And if you look under the microscope of patients with this disease, what you find are the small cells in the little arteries of the lung are proliferating and becoming so many cells that they occlude the vessels in the lung, causing the disease.
Is this specific disorder very difficult to detect and diagnose? And there's no known cause at this point, is that correct?
That's correct. There is no known cause except for that we can see pathologically these proliferating cells. And it is difficult to detect because there are many of the symptoms initially are nonspecific, fatigue, tiredness, a little bit of shortness of breath perhaps. And this blood test that we've developed allows us to detect it earlier than the current tests that are both invasive and non-invasive for the disease.
And tell us about the process, the experiments that you had to go through to kind of get this breakthrough blood test.
Well, my group has been working on a receptor pathway in the lung that this receptor is expressed on these cells that I was talking about. And in order to have cells divide, this pathway has to be turned on. And when the receptor is turned on, it's broken into little pieces. And one of those pieces is shed into the blood. And we've developed a method now to very carefully and accurately measure the levels of this piece in the blood. And so it is a correlate of disease severity. So it can be used, one, to screen patients, large populations, do you have the disease or not. It can be used to confirm the diagnosis in patients who are newly diagnosed with pulmonary hypertension. And we can use it to follow patients because the level of this protein in the blood correlate with disease severity. So someone comes in and says, I feel a little bit more short of breath on the medication I'm on. We can do a blood test and tell whether their disease is worsening or not.
Do you see this as a breakthrough discovery, and will it perhaps save lives?
Well, I hope so. This has been an exploratory study. We need to validate things in a larger patient population, including both very young people and old people, and for example, in patients that have not just pulmonary hypertension, but perhaps other lung diseases. But our hope is that it'll be used as a great diagnostic tool and a great prognostic tool in the future.
And what are the next steps to making this more available?
Well, we first studied 600 patients from both UC San Diego, Mass General Hospital, and the University of Arizona. And we need to expand our cohort to more populations, including both men and women, and minorities, and different ages, to prove that this is universally applicable for screening and treating this disease.
Sounds like you're very hopeful about this.
I am.
Yeah, that's good news. And happening right here in our own backyard. Love it.
Yes, sir.
Yeah.
Thank you, doctor. We appreciate your time. And bringing this up to speed on this is just fascinating.
Thank you.
All right. Thank you so much for being here.